You have to go and get more information, and we can't go on your image and get more information, right? So at this point, we can't. But in what you're going to read, you can get more information. Because you read a little bit, and you make inferences, and then you keep going back, and you keep checking. So let's take what you learned from your image, just so you can close your book. Let's take what you learned from your image into a little tiny passage, okay? This is the passage that's coming up next in your assessment. It's my learning target. It's called the gemstone of Karkar. Okay. So I want you to think about this as an image. So what if you had this information? What's the main kind of subject or character? Like I had an earthworm, some of you had a football, right? You had something that was the main thing. And then what could connect around to it? So I'm going to read it to you. You see if you can figure out the main character. Let's see if we can make any inferences based on things we can connect to the main character. So what he says, what he does, or what he thinks or feels. Let's see. The gemstone of Karkar. Once upon a time, in a faraway land, lived a young man named Jewel. For years, Jewel worked by his father's side weaving baskets. Okay, everybody tell me, who do you think is the main character?
Jewel.
Okay, there we go. So keep Jewel in the center and think of all the things, Finn, that connect to Jewel. What could it be? As he worked, so Jewel is working. As he worked, he dreamed of someday leaving his small village to see the world. Then he began hearing stories of the great city of Karkar and a powerful emperor who had a truly beautiful daughter. He decided that the time had come to leave home and find his destiny. What future can a poor boy hope to find in Karkar, his father asked. I will fall on my knees and beg the emperor to let me marry his daughter.
Did you expect him to say that?
Yes.
Yeah. I actually didn't. He's a hard worker. I didn't expect him to say he was just going to show up in the city and ask to marry the emperor's daughter. So think about what kind of a person might say, I'll just show up. I don't know her, and I'll just ask her to marry me. The emperor may take off your head for such rudeness, his father said. But Jewel was determined to go. So he's going to go. That's his action. He's going to walk up to the emperor and beg the emperor, please let me marry your daughter. He's been a worker in a far-off place in a little town, so I want you to turn to your partner and say, what inference can we make from this? And think together what we can say. So somebody share with me an inference. What's something that you connected to Jewel from the other clues that are here? Caitlin, can you tell us something you said about Jewel?
Yeah, I think he's greedy, but also I think I've read the story before.
Okay, so you might have some other clues. What makes you think he might be greedy?
Because he wants everything for himself, because he's going to beg the king.
So that's an inference. She connected what he wants to say with the main character, and she has an inference about that. Okay, let's take two more.
I think he kind of might be full of himself, because if he thinks he can actually walk up to the emperor and ask him to let him marry your daughter, I think he's pretty much.
Right? So both of you, as you're going forward and reading the story, you're going to have that in your mind and keep checking. Is that true? Are more things that he says and does kind of agreeing with my first inference? So now I'm starting to draw a conclusion about the main character. Okay, one more idea. Someone we haven't heard from right now.
That he's determined because how he's going to beg the emperor to marry his daughter. Even though his dad told him that.
So what do you learn about Jewel if he doesn't really listen to his dad? Could be determined or brave or unwise, right? There are lots of things we could think about him. Did you have another thought related to that? Wow. So maybe if he's just caring about his own life and nobody else's, then he'll do certain actions in the rest of the story. Exactly. One more thought.
I infer that he's going to try to go to the emperor and do what he said, ask if he can marry them.
And what made you think that?
Because at the end it says Jewel was very determined to go, and he just sounds like he really wants to go, and that like, at the end of the first paragraph, it says, he decided that the time had to come to leave home and find his destiny. He sounds very determined and wanting to go.
Mm-hmm. Do you see how your thinking is a little bit the same in your image? You had something in the center and things connected to it, and now we found the central person, Jewel, and we connected to that. So when you have more time to read the story, you can take your inference and keep checking it to see if more clues about Jewel help you think, he is determined, or he is full of himself, or he doesn't listen to others, or whatever it is, right? And that'll help you understand the story better. Nice job, and thanks for helping each other get that work done.